Joining me in the studio this afternoon is Paul Larson, producer at Mountain Lake PBS, and this is the second time I've had you in, which is always exciting because you and I have a lot in common. We talk about a lot of cool stuff. Today we're talking about something super cool, especially for our generation. There's going to be a special event at the Strand Center Theater in Plattsburgh. What's going on?
Well, Mountain Lake PBS has a very special free viewing of the Mr. Rogers documentary, Won't You Be My Neighbor, on the big screen at the Strand Theater on April 7th.
That's so cool. Just in time for my birthday. I'm excited.
Oh, how fun.
So what makes this an event as opposed to just a film screening?
Well, first of all, if you missed it on the big screen last summer, here's your big chance not to miss the big impact this beautiful film makes when it's projected so large with an audience full of people who all love Mr. Rogers. And it's also going to bring the messages of Mr. Rogers really close to home because we have a special guest.
Ooh.
We're bringing in François Clemmons from Middlebury, Vermont, and he used to play the singing police officer, Officer Clemmons. And we're all going to have the chance to ask him some questions about the program and about Mr. Rogers. He loves talking about those subjects. So it's going to be a very fun, informative, educational afternoon.
So when you see this movie, does revisiting Mr. Rogers as an adult change what you think of the show?
I think it forces adults in a very positive way to re-examine their rapport with Mr. Rogers. For me personally, being able to hear Mr. Rogers voice his philosophy about treating children as people who deserve attention and respect and kindness and who need some help understanding the wide world that we live in with all its flaws and its joys. That just increases my level of respect for Mr. Rogers when I see this film. And that level of respect was already very high. When my mother saw the documentary recently for the second time when it aired on PBS stations across the country, she called me up and she said, "I'm so happy that you and your sister got to grow up watching this wonderful program."
You know, he was a friend to all of us, and that's what makes this special. So, you know, if you have children or grandchildren and you grew up with him, like, this is something that you really should, as a family or even as just a group of friends, come and check this out, because, you know, Mr. Rogers is very important to our generation.
Absolutely he is.
Now, what's the message of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood that hits closest to home?
Well, at the end of every show, he would say, "I like you just the way you are. There's never been another you. There's never going to be another you. There's only one of you in the whole world." And then he would say, "You are special." And that always hit very close to home. My mother used to say the same thing to me.
You know, it makes me kind of tear up because it's kind of, you know, I think that I was talking earlier today. I was on a podcast earlier today, and that's kind of the message was, like, you know, about being kind. And I think that he taught a whole generation of kids to not only be kind to other people, but most importantly, to be kind to ourselves.
Absolutely. That was his main philosophy. Love yourself and love your neighbor.
Mm-hmm. Something we need a little bit more in this day and age. So who's the target audience for the event?
Well, strangely enough, it's not the little kids, ages 2 to 6, who were the target audience for Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. I'd say it's more for people like you and me, adults who grew up watching the show, and parents of kids who watched the show, like my mother.
Mm-hmm.
It was not her generation to watch that show, but she knew her kids were watching it. And grandparents who have seen their grandkids watch the show. I hear the movie does really well with senior citizens and all ages, really, except the littlest of kids. The subject matter does tend to get mature.
Right.
You remember Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood was not a show that denied there were bad things in the world.
Right.
He talked about death, war, and divorce, and these subjects are dealt with in the film, but in more of an adult way, because Mr. Rogers was helping prepare children to live in this big world. And also the discussion with François Clemmons might treat some mature topics as well. He's very frank in the way he talks with audiences. And people want to know these days, what would Mr. Rogers think of any given topic that's going on right now?
Right. Now, what are you looking forward to with this event?
Well, I'm really looking forward to François Clemmons answering the questions because he again, is so frank. And he loves to talk about Mr. Rogers, his very dear friend. He loves to talk about the program. So you're going to hear stories that no one else could tell you.
Right.
And also, I'm looking forward to hearing him sing with an accompanist.
Ooh, that's so cool.
He's going to sing this song. It's funny. I was on the phone with him, and we were talking about him possibly singing, because he sings gospel songs. Mm-hmm. And he said, I'll sing anything. I just don't want to sing anything from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. And I said, oh, my gosh, that's exactly what I wanted to hear, was a song from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, because it at the time I'd been editing a piece right. with him. I'd done an interview piece, and there was this one song I kept going back to in the story, and it was called There Are Many Ways to Say I Love You. And I thought, I would love to hear him sing that live. And luckily, he said, okay, Paul, for you, I'll sing that song.
Yay! That's something to look forward to. That's wonderful.
There are many ways to say I love you. There are many ways to say I care about you. Many ways, many ways, many ways to say I love you.
So, Paul, when is the event?
Sunday, April 7th at 3 p.m. at the Strand Center Theater in Plattsburgh, and you can head to mountainlake.org to RSVP for this free event.
And we would encourage people to always RSVP.
Absolutely, yes.
Well, Paul, thank you so much, and for all of your hard work for preserving this because, again, there is generations of children in the future that may not understand Mr. Rogers if it's not preserved. So I appreciate the hard work that you're doing so his legacy continues.
Well, I wish I could take the credit, but this is the hard work of many, many people to preserve the legacy of Fred Rogers, but I am so happy to do what I can to promote it.
Awesome. Well, Paul, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Won't you please, won't you please, please won't you be my neighbor?